that means pretty much I'm gonna be playing Getsu with a bunch of different characters, okay? And let's do this. Yeah, well, like, here's the thing about desyncs and stuff and, like, handoffs. You shouldn't rely on wobbling, definitely. But knowing how to wobble and wobbling at opportunities where you can wobble versus relying on wobbling is different. Alright, let's continue. Here's what I thought for the first match. Hello? Here's what I thought from your first match. Your, like, desync game is relatively solid. Like, you know what desync is and you know how to perform a few of them. Your Popo alone sucks. Like, Popo should be able to deal at least 40% to Fox. A couple of things that I do with Sopo against bad foxes, or just if you're fast enough it'll work against good foxes, is the down throw. If you grab and immediately down throw, You can chain it into another down throw if they don't DI away, and a lot of times if like you get a fast wave dash grab, down throw to down throw, you can get something nice off of that. Or like if they're at higher percents and you know they won't DI away, whether it's because you're inputting the down throw really fast or whether it's because they're a noob, you can get like grab to forward smash or grab to down smash. You can do that against Falcon as well. So here, let me separate your, or do you like know how to play box semi well enough? Oh no, you don't need to be good. I'll just show you kind of like the my playstyle against box. Sorry, it's taking me a little bit to warm up.
No worries.
Also here, wait, let me show you something, okay?
Yeah.
Something that, do you know Antic?
I do not.
Top Ice is an organ. Something that he'll do is he'll do a pivot, decent ice block. Which, once you get, like, the hang of, do you see that?
Yeah, well, you use like the dashing animation instead of make Nana do it.
What?
You use like, you dash dance to make Nana like shoot it out instead of poke.
Yeah, like that.
Okay, yeah.
That's a great way to approach. And then of course this approach is also great. Which is like two dash dances and you down me with that. Alright, let's go. Rip. So, kind of a little bit like that. Alright, a couple of other desyncs that you might like is the tilt desync. And also, one of my favorite ones is the grab to blizzard, where you whiff a grab and then you go straight to blizzard. If you see Antic, like if you search up Antic, he's good. Of course, you've seen Wobbles and stuff. Stuff that Wobbles does is a little bit insane for a little bit more practical stuff. Look at like Antic or Diskhead Bookie. Here, I'm gonna choose a character you have trouble with and I can play them. Alright, choose one. No, play the Icies. I'm not. It's you bragging the Icies. The only reason was I kind of wanted to show you something. Alright, let's do a Captain Falcon. It's your stage. Missed the moonwalk. was really good. I just DI straight away. So basically it's like, it's more of a DI mix-up than anything when you down throw chain grab me. So if you can get it fast enough, like I don't expect you to be getting grab and you can get a chain grab, it's the same kind of thing with the, do you know the down throw down air wobble setup? One of my other favorite wobble setups to do, it's a little bit more stylish. Play someone so I can just show you, okay? Like Falcon or something. It's not as guaranteed, but it's still really fun. Yeah, it's a grab. Here, come here. Grab, down throw, and then hammer, and you have to time the hammer so it sends them down and you get a jab reset. It's really fun to do. But other than down throw down air, if you can't do that setup, go for like just a down throw dash attack. I don't know how much easier that is. It's a little bit easier to DI away, but here, if you play Falcon again, I can show you. Like, just do it with no DI, okay? You have to be at the right percent. Or maybe it's like a certain DI. There we are. Yeah. So with like that, like you have to be at a certain percent and it's not as good, but if like you know they DI like really weird, like straight up or something, then you can get them with that. Or you can just go through for like a chain grab, do you think? What? Let's do the Ganondorf. Oh yeah, another thing about Captain Falcon. Bladewise told me this for Peach, and I think it goes well for Isis as well. With Captain Falcon, like, he's better than you, he beats you. You have to be at least 3 steps ahead of him, or else he just beats you based off of speed. So like, you kind of have to read what they do like 3 steps ahead of them, and then you can beat them. Also, you're not projectiling enough. Icy's have a really okay projectile and can be used for spacing and stuff. Don't projectile too much, but there are gaps in your play that you're not doing anything with that could be suited by projectile or a pivot projectile. Like desync projectile. Let's do this. I don't care about the tempo, okay? Ganondorf's one of the few characters I consider myself a decent with. Nice dash out of that. Thank you. here's what I have to say about this matchup. It's a losing matchup for you. Obviously. Ganondorf can and will separate you. If the Ganondorf can get shield grab, of course get shield grab, but most of his moves are too powerful, so he can just space them on shield really well and you'll just take shield damage. So, shielding versus Ganondorf is only used, like, if you know it's a move that's about to be shield grabbed. Another thing about Ganondorf, wobbling's really important, and every move of Ganondorf's is laggy, and it's going to hit one of your ice climbers. So, when Ganondorf is bullying your Nana, make sure that your Popo's nearby, like, waiting where, like, the move is hitting the Nana and steadying outside there so he can hit the Ganondorf and punish for hitting the Nana. Or else you're just gonna get bodied by three moves from the Ganondorf. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, you're, like, accept that you're getting hit, and accept that you're desynced, and just work on getting the Ganondorf in its end leg, punishing him for hitting your Nana. Any other characters you want to play? I main Peach. Let's do this. Here's the thing about Peach. There's a couple of ways that you can play against Peach, and you have to recognize what type of Peach it is, okay? So, if the Peach is doing a lot of dash attacks, and like playing more grounded, then Shield Grab is your best friend. Shield Grab to Wobble. Because a lot of time, Peach will just like, and this is my mentality when playing against Ice Climbers too as a Peach. This is a winning matchup for me, so I will win. Sheik. You can go in with a neutral air if you go in really fast. When I play against my local Peach with Ice Climbers, honestly, the way that I beat him, and I do beat him pretty consistently, is I'm always going in. Ice Climbers are deceptively fast. Not a lot of people play them aggressively. And so, if I always go in and I've used the, the disjointed hitbox on my hammers, you can surprise a lot of Peaches, because a lot of Peaches don't have an answer for, they're attacking me, I'm supposed to be attacking them. Yeah. The playstyle that I use against Ice Climbers is a one that a bunch of Peaches will use against Ice Climbers. It's the, I'm better, this should be a win matchup, so I'm just going to use what moves I have that I know that is really hard for Ice Climbers to deal with, instead of actually thinking of this like actual mashup. So like, I'll spam down smash because it's really hard for you to deal with it. I will spam like back airs because it's really hard to deal with it. Spam forward airs and I won't actually play the game. And this gets beaten by Ice Climbers just being like, he's down smashing. Why would I try and grab him? A lot of Ice Climbers will leave their shield to grab the down smash instead of like running in with a nair. Yeah, just. Oh no, you know what you're doing. Like. That's very clear when, like, you know what you're doing, you get a few desyncs, and, like, you're playing relatively solidly. You're not too defensive, which is good. You need to tighten up your punish game a lot. Icy's have the best punish game, and you should be wobbling. Every single grab you get should be an attempt to wobble. So, like, I don't care if you mess up the wobble, as long as you're attempting to wobble, because that's how you get better. What do you mean? Here, play another character, and I'll show you what I mean by wobble. So, let me try and do the one where I do it after Nana with her grab, okay? Yeah, you'll just, here, wait, let me try again. Yeah, you'll just do a down throw. Not really instantly. Another thing that you can do if you like want to get a desync is you can try and jump with Nana. Like, now I'm just seeing if this works because I've Yep, it worked. To be honest, I didn't. I honestly didn't know if that would work, but. That, like, with ice climbers especially, it's really important that you get quick off the execution, because if you're not, then the opponent, if they're a high level player, or like mid to high level player, will just mash out. So what I do is, once I get the grab, I just tap A, and then continue tapping A while moving my control stick slowly down. Like, it's just like... What? I just hold it down. Because if I had to tap back and forth, I would accidentally down smash or forward smash if I was doing it forwards. And that's why I say move slowly down. Because, like, if you're tapping slightly down, you still get a down tilt. So if you move slowly down, you'll get the just like a down tilt, and it's really easy to hold it there. Like, you get a grab, and then you're doing it at the rhythm of the wall. Because if you think of it as, like, three separate steps, it's really confusing. But if you just think of it like, grab, wobble, then you're good. You know what I mean? A couple of my favorite conversions in low percent here at Killer Self. They're all dependent on DI, which is why, like, I don't do them. But if I notice the opponent's really good at struggling out, and I showed you one of them here. I showed you one of them with the down air, right? Another one that I do. Oh my god, this is fucking stage. Another one I do if, like, the opponent is really fast at struggling, is I'll do a down throw, up smash. How to do what? Like this? Okay, so for the down throw handoff, you wait until there's a little green area, and then you re-grab. Did you see that? So, like, the little green spike, exactly then you re-grab. It's a little bit different for every timing. As for the other one, it's more like, it's like a tap and then boom, and then tap, wait, boom. It's like, I do it better when, like, I'm listening to music or something, because, like, you get the groove in. But, like, just kind of practice the timing with that. The down throw handoff, though, is just the little green bit. Now, another thing. If you're going for handoffs near the ledge, you know about the thing where Nana always forward throws? Did you see that, where Nana always forward throw? The problem is, like, the forward throw is easier and more consistent, but with Popo, like, if you have Popo and you have to have Nana grab, she moves forward a little bit, so you'll end up going to ledge where Nana will teeter and not be able to do anything. So if you're gonna go for the handoffs, make sure sure that Nana, well, Nana's guaranteed forward throw, but always get the handoff from Popo if you're near the ledge like this, off the down throw, or else, you, like, the handoff won't last very long. I don't need to take a break, I like melee. Yeah, another however long you want. Which other character do you want to play? You want me to play? Jigglypuff is really hard. I used to be like gold and I've beaten platinum masters before. I just don't really care about my rank anymore due to the fact that I just want to play as many good people as I can. I've beaten platinum masters before. Alright, you ready?
Ready?
Omzatech. When they know you about to blow, you gotta know that we in control. Do you know what Arms Attack is? Oh no, it's Amza with like an H. Basically what it is you're kind of like DIing some moves. You can DI like kind of a little bit towards the stage and tech it. It's hard to explain, but like if you like ASDI and SDI, you can't SDI really towards the stage. But like you kind of can, like here, it became second nature to me a little bit ago, but you just kind of like hold down and like crouch cancel and tech, but like diagonally down. Kind of, yeah. I can't tell as we can. Search online how to Amza with an H tech, and there will be something. Like this? Here. Were you trying to do that stall? Oh yeah, yeah. That one's actually pretty hard. The problem is, yeah, exactly. You have to wait until you're just a little bit below. Like if you're at the level of the stage, then it won't happen. Alright, ready? Thank you. How long have you been playing? Oh, nice. Yeah, I mean, I play for around 7 hours a day. It's alright. Yeah, sure, we can stop tonight. Let me stop recording.